Edward, Private Harry, is it dangerous?
Wouldn't pay so nice if it weren't.
But why not sail with the King's Navy? Earn a proper wage, sail under gentlemen.
Sod the Navy's gentlemen. For every shilling I earn, the captain gets 600. That's no way to earn a fortune.
We don't need a fortune.
It's not about need, Caroline. I want food that don't make me sick. I want walls that hold back the wind. I want a decent life.
How long would you be gone with these privateers?
A year, I reckon. Two at the most.
All right. No more than two. Promise me.
Was it good for you as well?
Havana. I must get to Havana.
Or I'll just build us another ship, will I?
I can pay you. Isn't that the sound you pirates like best? 100 escudos.
Keep talking.
Oh, don't
You don't have that cold on you now, do you? Come on, mate. We're off to a bad start. It's 100 leagues or more to Havana. Will you walk that distance? We could work together on this.
Señor Duncan Wildwood, I accept your most generous offer and await your arrival with eagerness. If you truly possess the information we desire, we have the means to reward you handsomely. Though I would not know your face by sight, I believe I can recognize the costume of infamous by your secret order. Therefore, come to Havana in haste, and trust that you shall be welcomed as a brother. So must you leave this episode. El gobernador Loreano Torres y Ayala.
screw will do me just fine.
You saved me. A profusion of thanks.
Is that yours?
It is my vessel, yes. But here lies its poor captain, and I have no art for sailing.
I can pilot her myself, not mine.
You don't mean to abscond with my ship, do you?
I'm Duncan. What's your name, Fred?
Steve Bonnet.
Well, Mr. Bonnet, let this stay twixt us. But I'm on a secret errand for His Majesty the King, God save him, and I must get to Havana with speed.
Oh, that is a relief, sir. Havana is also my destination. Our ways lie together.
Natural allies, then.
You put me at ease, sir. Do you think I took you for a pirate when you first appeared?
Did you?
Yes. You have an uncommon way of handling yourself. Quick and easy, if I may say. Gave me quite a fright. All things considered, I think it's turned out to be a rather fortuitous day, hasn't it?
Lacking a rowboat, I'm afraid we'll have to swim to my ship.
Hardly the worst thing to happen.
I should have taken the coat off.
Mains up! Let's go!
Welcome aboard, Duncan. She's a modest schooner, but well suited to my purpose, trafficking cargo for my plantation and such.
She'll do fine. There's a strong wind now. Let's strike to full, shall we?
Ah, there's a tug of the wind in my hair. Ah, I find a bracing comfort in the feel and smell of the ocean. The raw stink of possibility.
That's a top way of seeing it, mate.
By the idea of pirates roaming these waters.
Is it a real danger, do you suppose?
A possibility. For most pirates storm the bridge of passage between Cuba and Hispaniola.
Oh, I see. Yes. That is a bustling strait. But I shouldn't worry about being waylaid by pirates, truth be told. My ship is small, and I have nothing of immense value. Sugarcane, which is yields. Molasses, rum, that sort of thing.
There's not a pirate living on his back with kegs of rum.
Oh, yes. Yes, I suppose that's true.
Reef it, all caught! As much sail as you can! Douse the gallants aboard! Loose all, twin shot to the wind.
You're a natural sailor, Duncan.
I did a decent trick at the helm some time ago. 2 years before the mast as a privateer.
Dash my buttons. Your life seems a grand one, if I may say. So full of adventure. How marvelous.
I've seen my share of strangeness, aye.
Promising.